Welcome to another video. Today we'll be reviewing Army of the Dead. This one came out on Friday and was directed by Zack Snyder and stars Dave Bautista and Hiroyuki Sanada. Now before we start, hit that like button, subscribe to the post notification bell so you can be notified for your video. Let's start talking about the good. So all the actors and actresses in this film, I thought they're all fantastic. Especially Dave Bautista and Hiroyuki Sanada. They're both fantastic in this film. I thought the opening sequence was great. It sets the tone of the film, and it captured my attention immediately. The cinematography, which of course includes the shots, the camera angles, the lighting, it was fantastic. Zack Snyder has his own type of, his own way of filming movies, and he has a specific style to his cinematography, and this film definitely screams Zack Snyder. If you just look at the shots in this film, look at the way he sets up the camera and a lot of the sequences in this film, you can tell that it's a Zack Snyder film, especially the visuals. The visuals look like typical visuals from Zack Snyder. They're bright visuals, and they fit the tone of the film perfectly. Because this film is, it's very lighthearted. This film is very lighthearted. And of course it's a horror film, it is a zombie heist film, but the lighthearted sequences balance out with the horror sequences in this film. So you can tell by the way the film looks. The zombies and the practical and special effects are fantastic. Zack Snyder does a great job clearly with zombie films. Dawn of the Dead is possibly the best zombie film that I've ever seen. I didn't see the 1978 one, but the 2004 Dawn of the Dead is the best zombie film that I have ever seen. And the reason it was so good was because Zack Snyder uses practical and special effects, but he uses them in a way that is entertaining, and the practical effects look real. The blood, all that stuff looks very real in this film, so the practical and special effects are fantastic. I thought the story was great. It's not a complicated story. It is just a bank heist film. That's basically all it is. Just a heist film with zombies. That's basically what the film is. There is some story elements with Dave Bautista's character, where his character does go deeper than what you see in the beginning of the film. He is a deeper character, and he does have a lot of character development, but the story is just a clean story. It's just a regular zombie heist film. There's no extra elements in there. It's just a simple story, but it works for the film. The score I thought was very, very well done. Now, it's not John Williams or Michael Giacchino or anything like that, but the score for this film is fantastic, especially during those dark sequences where you can feel the intensity and you can feel the characters' emotions within the film, and you can sense that zombies are near them, someone's about to die. So the score I thought was fantastic. The action sequences. Now the action sequences are awesome. Zack Snyder does a great job with filming his action sequences. And this film in particular has some great action sequences that look magnificent. In the trailer, you probably already saw the explosions and all that, but they look very well done in this film. And the action sequences are awesome. The thrills and suspense are implemented in this film perfectly. Now, this film does have a lot of thrills and a lot of suspense. That is placed very well in this film. You have, obviously, the first act, which, of course, introduces the characters and their motivations for what they're doing. And the second act of the film, of course, goes into more of the story, more of setting up what's going to happen in the third act, but also giving you a lot of action. And then the third act, of course, is that final payoff, that final battle. And I think it all works for the film. Now, the first and second acts of the film should be strong acts of the film, but not as strong as the third act should be. Now, the first and second acts of the film are fantastic because I was interested right with the opening sequence. The opening sequence drew my attention, like I said in the beginning of this review. So the first, second, and third acts of the film are fantastic. There are some hilarious sequences within this film. Now, Zack Snyder does a great job with blending comedy and horror in his films. This film has a lot of comedy, and it works with the horror elements of this film. There are a lot of tense sequences within this film. Now, Zack Snyder does a great job with his tense sequences. Like I said, Dawn of the Dead is one of the best or possibly the best zombie film that I've ever seen. And the tense sequences in Dawn of the Dead 2004 are fantastic. It was just extremely tense. And this film does the same thing, but I didn't think it was as tense as Dawn of the Dead, because Dawn of the Dead wasn't really comedy. It was pretty much a straight-out horror film. But this one is a horror film, but with some comedy in it. So I thought the sequences that were supposed to be tense were tense. There are some emotional sequences within this film, especially with Dave Bautista's character and his relationship with his daughter in this film. I thought was fantastic, and it is used in an emotional way in the third act of the film and the end of the film, where it all ties together, and I thought it was fantastic. The zombies. Now, the zombies are very, very, very different than any other zombies that I've ever seen in any zombie horror film. These zombies in this film are organized, and just by the way they act in the film, you can tell that they're very different from any other zombie film. You'll see, if you see the film, you'll know what I'm talking about. I'm not going to spoil what they do, but I'm just going to say that they're organized and very different from any zombies that I have ever seen in any zombie horror film. The third act of the film is awesome and action-packed. I really like that about Zack Snyder's films, because basically all of his films have that awesome third act that you just can't wait to get to. And most of his films, possibly all of his films, I haven't seen all of them, but most of them are obviously very well done, but you always want to wait to finish the film just to get to that third act, because Dawn of the Dead has an awesome third act. This film has an action-packed third act that was just visually stunning, and on a character level, it was fantastic. That third act of the film is action-packed and very, very entertaining. And the ending sequence, there's an emotional sequence in the third act of the film right near the ending sequence, and it is very emotional because this character, you are invested in this character because, of course, Zack Snyder does a great job with his characters, with his writing for his characters, and the way he sets up his characters and different things that happen in the film to different characters. Fantastic. And that's why the emotional sequence in that third act of the film paid off. That's all the good that I have. Now let's move on to the bad. So I guess the only bad thing I have to say about this film is that there are some cliche moments within the film. Now, it doesn't take away from my overall enjoyment of the film, but it is something that I noticed, that some sequences feel like sequences that we've seen before in other films. But other than that, I had a fantastic time with this film. Army of the Dead is a very entertaining zombie horror film. It's one of the most fun films of 2021 so far, and I highly recommend it. And I'm going to give Army of the Dead a B+. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe, post notification bell so you can get a free video. I'm Peter. Thank you for watching.